Tensions with China has escalated yet again, with two Australian journalists fleeing the country after being questioned over a national security case. Political reporter Taylor Aiken is live with the details. Taylor, good morning to you. Troubling news. Take us through it this morning.
Good morning, Anne. Well, following warnings from DFAT, two Australian foreign correspondents have been rushed out of China and put on the next flight home. The ABC's Bill Birtles and Mike Smith from the Australian Financial Review boarded a flight last night following a diplomatic standoff with Beijing. It's understood the situation escalated last week when Chinese authorities attempted to question both men about detained television anchor and Australian citizen Chung Lei. That then led to both men seeking refuge in Australian missions in China as Australian diplomats worked to secure their safe departure. It's understood an interim travel ban was only lifted after they agreed to be interviewed by China's Ministry of State Security. The pair arrived in Sydney a couple of hours ago and had this to say about their experience.
It's so good to be home, so happy. I can't say any more at the moment, but such a relief to be home, so really happy.
Did you feel threatened at all when you were over there?
A little bit, yes. It was a complicated experience, but it's great to be here.
I'll just say it's very disappointing to have to leave under those circumstances, and it's a relief to be back in a country with genuine rule of law.
This is just the latest development in rising tensions between Australia and China, with the relationship being strained in recent months over trade tensions, the COVID-19 pandemic and the detention of Ms. Lei. The Foreign Minister, Maurice Payne, has put out a statement confirming consular assistance had been provided to the pair, along with all Australian citizens currently being detained, while also renewing advice to not travel to China, warning Australians could face arbitrary detention. Anne.
Taylor Aiken in Canberra. Thank you, Taylor.